There are some advanced aspects. We are talking about it since morning, like PFA, DIS, air combing test, some other tests also, including acoustic test, that are compatible only with Exponent software, not with Hive. Apart from the attachments, we have some other peripherals also. You can see the picture of DIS and PFA also here. I have listed. It's from the software itself. You can see the list from there also. So these are compatible only with the Exponent software. That makes it more versatile. And the same instrument can be used for different peripherals also. You can attach a Alice system. You can attach an integrated balance. You can attach a video capture sync system. It will capture the video while you are doing your test, and it will record step by step what point will be there. I mean, if it's a fracture, it will record that, and you will come to know that in what fashion the fracture has occurred. It will be compatible to Exponent only. AED also, these things are compatible with Exponent only. Some other variables are there for temperature maintenance or temperature thing. We have thermal cabinets which can go up to minus 40 to plus 23 degrees centigrade of the atmosphere. And here cabinet we have, these are also compatible with Exponent only. Now, not the least, we have recently introduced enhanced security module for pharma, which is developed in accordance to 21 CFR FDA protocol. Yeah, and this is supported only by Exponent software, not by any other Exponent type or any other mode. So these are some features or some guidelines on how it is developed and why it is developed. So it is developed in accordance with FDA 21 CFR Part 11 guidelines. It is to provide electronic record and signature management. There is a specific user feature to improve security and customer information. And you can continuously monitor and track, like audits and all, you can do that. Right, in the ESM module. It's an attachment to Exponent software. It's a peripheral software for Exponent. Some important features are there. It has a logon password, and you need to validate it again and again periodically, like 21 CFR requires. You can create multiple level of user profile, which are available with electronic records and signatures. It can copy and print out audit trails, which will clearly make visible the results and records for a long time. And protective security will detect and notify any attempt or unauthorized use of password. No one can use your instrument without your permission, and it will allow you to trace that and who has tried to unauthorizedly do this. I mean, the password trying. There are some more features of the ESM. We have a strict password checking option, and we can create multiple login options also. You can use the window name, or it has a sample box also, like simple box, and even advanced list which includes IT administrator and all. So you can control the login options also. You can enforce wrong password also, which includes different characters, including digits and characters. And you can lock program after X minutes of inactivity. And here are some others. Then you can specify logout time, specify password validity. You want to change your password within 1 month, you can specify a time period of 1 month only. And a number of unique password required before use. You can require how many passwords you can store in that. Right? And you can lock things like performing calibration, logging in, logging out, to change the option in the software. You can, as an admin, you can lock everything. Or unlock also. Some other options. You can force the user to change their password when they next log in. It is not like that whenever a user leaves the organization, you cannot control that. You can also do that. And also you can force them whenever they are doing next login, they have to change the password. So it will make it more robust or more protective, more secure software. It has a reminder for like login password. And it can also prevent user to change their password. It's like admin control. When the admin doesn't want, they cannot change their password. Everything is in the hand of admin. And the admin can disable user account also temporarily or permanently also. And admin can assign rights to different users to perform actions and calculations and many other things, many tasks. And even you can check, everything is like customizable. Whatever you are doing in Exponent, you can lock or unlock by this feature. ESM. The ambition was very boring, was like kind of theoretical, so I did different pictures also. These are like the screenshots from this ESM module. So it is like the admin can lock the login name and users also, and these activities also. If I am an admin, I can, for let's say Mahesh, I can lock these four commands or these five commands, and these will do any other activity. So it is the hand of admin. And since it's a new thing, in case you want any information, just please write to us. We'll be happy to share more information on this. Any question? Right. Yeah, this is a peripheral software. You have to buy this and you can attach it with Exponent software. So this is called ESM for Exponent software. Yes. For Pharma, it's a good thing because quite a long time we are receiving queries from Pharma that it should be 21 CFR compliant. So that is why SNS come up with this. This will be 4 lakh plus taxes. Any query, please write to this address. I'll take a leave then. Next session is thank you very much for signing off today. Yeah, please enjoy your tea, then we will continue further.
So before moving forward to some more information, so I just wanted to have a relook at the points that we noted down at the start of the day today. So read out the queries and please let me know if your expectations have been met or not. Utilization of texture analyzer for research, food and pharma. Operation of texture analyzer, I hope that was covered in very detail. Interpretation of data. Use of different probes. Creating macros. Tests that can be done on packaging films. Effective use of software for interpreting the data. Pharmaceutical applications of the instrument. Writing the projects. And of course, Deepesh added one more point for troubleshooting. And he successfully completed that. Two ticks. Yeah. Right, so in case you still have any query that you want us to solve, any specific question that needs to be answered, please write us at techsupport@sdsinstruments.com. We'll be happy to help you out. And we can move on to the next session. That is mainly for the...
Hello everyone, I am Saurabh.